Good morning, everybody. I'm just getting everything plugged in and set up. We are simulcasting again on Ustream and Periscope. I should be able to see all the comments everywhere, hopefully. But if some of my art partners, admins, are online, maybe you can help me if I miss a question. Yes, Erin, these are the Prima watercolors. I just got them. Because you all know that I may be able to avoid buying more paper, pens, but watercolor paint? There's no way on the planet. Like, I see a new brand of watercolor paint and I want it. Like, I don't know. Ay-ay-ay, it's expensive. So, we're going to find out, Erin. And hi! And we are going to compare the Primas. We're going to do a similar little study paintings. We're going to work on just some plain watercolor paper. We're going to do some studies. And I'll explain what these calendars are for in a minute. We're going to use the Primas. And we're also going to use these. I was requested to try these. This is my MaimeriBlue palette. I don't have lots of colors, but I do have enough that we can work with them. So we're going to experiment with these and the Primas. I do, of course, have my Daniel Smiths out because they're always out. These are the ones, of course, you know I use all the time. But for today, we're going to set the Daniel Smith aside. And we're going to focus on the Primas and the MaimeriBlue. And we're going to do a couple of quick little paintings with both, and we'll probably do some swatching and stuff of the Primas and the MaimeriBlues and that kind of thing. We're going to just play this morning. All right, so I've just got some 8x8 watercolor paper on a fluid watercolor paper block. This is 140-pound cold press. I like the cold press, as most of you know, because it has a little bit of a texture, so I like that. So we're going to be working on that this morning. I didn't have enough time to go get another cup of coffee, and I really feel like I need one. Anyway, these are a bunch of calendars by So I like the fluid block paper, but I never tape it down to anything because it's in a block. So that's okay, I can manage. So because it's in a block, it's glued on at least two sides. So when you work with it, you don't have to worry about taping it down to anything. When I'm stretching paper on a paper stretcher or taping it down, I prefer Fabriano watercolor paper. I almost always like cold press, or Fabriano makes a soft press, which still has a little bit of a texture, but it's a little bit less than your standard cold press. But I like my watercolor paper to have a little bit of a texture in it. That's a personal thing. You just have to try. My local art supply store last summer, had Fabriano paper come do a demo at my local art supply store. And part of the demo, they gave us free paper samples of all their different kinds of paper. So I would look at your local fine art supply store and see if they have demos coming up for the spring and summer, or even they may even have some fall demos. This particular art store has them year round, and see if and when they're having one of the paper companies come out, maybe Strathmore, maybe Fabriano. And because when they do these demos, they give out paper samples, and that's a great way to try a bunch of different kinds of watercolor paper. Okay, so these calendars are done by a friend of my husband. They actually work together in the tech industry, but as a side job, Brent is a photographer. His name is Brent Frazier, and unbeknownst to me, we've been married a long time, but I don't know. I guess we just assume each other knows stuff. But anyway, I had no idea. My husband's been buying these calendars from him for years. And finally, he said, hey, you know, I have all these calendars from Brent. He's a photographer. I've been saving them because I like the images. Would you like them for reference material for your art? I said, well, if I can use them in some live broadcasts on YouTube, and if Brent's okay with that, And he said, I'll ask him. And Brent, of course, was okay with it as long as I say who the photographs are by. So anyway, I have all these calendars now. And look at some of these images. There's the dogwood flowers. If you saw my messy sketch YouTube video, this is the image that I drew it from. And so I have all of these calendars now with these wonderful, wonderful images. And if you would like to get one of Brent's calendars, he has a website. It is brentfraserphotography.com. There's those for you on, oops, on Periscope. I don't know how to do a screenshot. I have no idea. And for those of you on Ustream, oh, you screen. Yeah, so save it. So it's brentfraserphotography.com. BrentFraserphotography.com. I can never remember how to do like screenshots, screen capture. Like I can never remember. Anyway, I make lots of notes. You all know that if you've been watching me. So I picked one of the images this morning that I really liked to, if not paint, to at least take inspiration from for colors. I really love this photo. So we're going to work on that. And I'm going to stick it back here somewhere so I can see it. You guys will only see like part of it. Okay, so, oh, cool. So, I know Brent has a brand new 2016 calendar. That's the one I don't have. It's at my husband's desk. So you probably can go to his website and buy this one, that one. If he has any of his old calendars, this particular one we're working from is the 2013 calendar, FYI. And this is the photograph for May. And it is this beautiful sunset picture. It says Cannon Beach, Oregon. So we're going to work with that. All right, so on the MaimeriBlues, I have not really done much with them since I bought them except make the color swatch, the color key. that's all I've done. See, you guys are going to have to like make me, send me a PM and remind me because I keep having to like text my husband during the day. How do I do this? I think I drive him crazy. I know I drive him crazy. I shouldn't say think because I know I drive him crazy. So I am also working on trying to get samples of different paint brands, samples, free samples for me because I can't afford to buy any more watercolor paint. So hopefully coming soon is, hi, is I have sent messages to Old Holland, so hopefully they'll send some samples, and also a little known, unless you're really serious into watercolor, Italian brands, you have to like go to Italy to buy. Anyway, I messaged the guy and he said, we don't normally do this, but let me send you some things. So I have a couple of specialty brands hopefully coming. Hopefully, at least one of them I know. The Italy one for sure is coming. I haven't heard back from Old Holland, but I'm going to get the MaimeriBlues wet with my squirt bottle. And then these just came. I ordered mine from Amazon. They were in Amazon Prime, and I love that they come in a metal box. You all know I love the metal box. The only plastic palette that I like for my watercolors is the big round one when I'm having lots of people over. You can see I haven't even opened them yet. My only gripe is, and this is just how Prima does stuff, this is what they did with their pencils too. Hey! Is they have them 12 colors in 3 separate boxes. Y'all know that's going to make me crazy. So I did order a bigger box, like this one from Jackson's Art in the UK. So when it comes, I will be taking all of my Prima watercolors out of these smaller boxes and putting them in one bigger box. These little boxes are great. They make great travel kits. I don't know yet. I'm opening them fresh on camera, and we're going to paint. I only am live on Wednesdays and every other Monday. Oh, see, look at that one. It just is all out all over the place. I don't remember exactly. I got them on Amazon. I want to say they were like 20 or 25 each set of 12. Now, when you get these boxes, you actually sometimes can fit one more pan in the box. In this particular one, it looks like you can't. You can also squeeze squeeze these down, so when you snap the little half pan in, it stays in. No, they're not. The price wasn't bad, and if the Prima watercolor pencils are anything to go by, then I think that the quality is going to be really good. So this is what each set looks like. This one is the Decadent Pies. This one is, I mixed them all up now. This is the Classics. And this one is Tropicals, which you can tell because the colors are a lot brighter. And, you know, you can just pick, the one thing that is nice about having them separated like this is if you know you're like a brights girl and or guy, and you really like, you know, mainly bright colors when you're painting, then you can get the Tropicals. You have a nice little set of 12 colors, and especially if you're using them in conjunction with mixed media, and you're doing little greeting cards, things like that, this is a perfect, you know, selection of colors to play with like that. I missed that part about the Prima watercolor pencils, except that you sold them. I like my Prima watercolor pencils. I also have Inktense. They don't. The closest one would be the Decadent Pies. There are lots of neutral colors in here. We're going to open these and we're going to swatch them. So. And we're going to let the MaimeriBlue sit for a minute because they need to sit a little bit and they need to get juicy. So when you get professional watercolors, they come like this. Those of you. Yeah, I have Inktense and I have a few Durant, but I also have Primas. So when you get artist grade watercolors, professional watercolors in cake form, this is how they come. Little individually wrapped little pans. And they're honestly, when I got my Schminks, I was so excited, but unwrapping them is a pain in the neck. I should have done this before I turned the cameras on, but I didn't. So one thing I do, we're mixed media artists, right? Don't throw these little labels away. You can save those and use them on something. So the closest one to skin tones is going to be in the Decadent Pie set. They have this color here, which is a skin tone. We haven't gotten there yet. This is the, I've lost track again. I don't have my reading glasses on. That's part of the problem. They do have one in the Decadent Pie set. It looks like there's a couple of those that, yeah, exactly, on Mass Journal. There's a couple of colors in the Decadent Pie set that could be used as skin tones or that you could use to mix skin tones easily. I know. Well, you have to, you know, dedicate a space for the things you're saving. And when that space is full, you need to either purge before you save more or you need to just stop saving. Okay, so this one is, it says just color 13. Okay, see, that's going to be my first gripe. The little pans are not marked. I have a color number. It says 13. I don't know what color that is. Yep. So that's my first gripe, is they have the little labels on here. They're numbered, but there's no color name. So They're numbered. Yeah, they're numbered. So what I'm going to do is, as I'm unwrapping them, is I'm going to take a permanent marker and I'm going to write the number on the bottom of the little plastic pan. Yeah, that. So then you want to, now I heard the same thing. So when you open up a new watercolor set like this one, and the pan is not marked with the color, make sure you get a permanent marker out and write it on there, because when you go to buy a replacement, you need to know which one it is you're out of. The finer quality, of course, more expensive watercolors like Schmink, which is, you know, I have a set of Schminks. They're ginormously expensive, but they do mark their pans. So you don't have to do this part. I've lost track of which set this is. I think this might be the Tropicals, which is good because I think that's the set that we want if we're going to compare them to the MaimeriBlue. And there may be duplicates. Hi! There may be duplicates if they're watercolors or anything like the pencils. The pencils came in different color way sets like this. And then when you took them all out of the metal boxes, there were duplicates. So it is possible that there are duplicates. And if that's the case, when I transfer these to a different box, so all three sets are together, then I will be putting the duplicates in my spares drawer. I have a drawer for, you know, spares and extra paint when I run out of something. Well, oh yeah, welcome New Zealand. I'm doing a you and me swap with somebody from New Zealand. I just got her stuff yesterday. I know this is probably exciting for you guys all to watch me do this, but I should have done it before we got on live. Sorry about that. This is a good time to ask me questions, though. So just use a permanent, like, you know, waterproof marker or a Sharpie. This is one that I got as a gift from, this is a Lowe's brand. Hey, Malaysia. Wow. So we're opening up one of these sets of Prima watercolors. This is the Tropicals. Uh-oh, what color is this? Anybody see? I think it's 20. See, talking and writing at the same time. I can't multitask anymore. Anybody else have that problem? I used to be able to multitask. Then menopause happened. All right. Almost done. Because I know this is just so exciting. So I ordered these from Amazon. I consider me one of these normal people, you guys. I don't get lots of free products, honestly, because I don't ask. I ordered these from Amazon recently. It was Amazon Prime. They came in a couple days. So go over to Amazon. Yeah, they're on Amazon. And they had, last time I checked, they had all three sets. Right now. You're welcome. Okay, I think we're good. So you're going to need to do that to each one of them because they all come wrapped like that. Hey! So they all come wrapped like that. I'm only going to do the one because you guys do not want to sit and watch me for 10 minutes unwrapping all of them. If we are done doing a little paint comparison with both of these brands, then maybe I'll do something, but maybe I'll open the others. So I'm going to get I'm going to get the Primas wet. I don't worry too much about that, what just happened. Some of them just, you know, the green went into the blue. That was because it was holding it up, which you shouldn't do. You should just do it when it's flat so it doesn't do that. Oops, got watercolor paint on the husband's iPad. Oops, don't tell him. Shh. All right, let's see. We've got a couple of brushes. And first, let's try the MaimeriBlue. MaimeriBlue, I don't see any comments over on Ustream. Any chat things? I think that's just because there's nobody chatting, but that's fine. All right, so MaimeriBlue I got from Dick Blick. You can get them in a couple different places. It's a tube watercolor. They don't have cakes. So I squeeze them out of the tube and put them into a pan. I do have a whole set of gouache. I don't use them too much. I like the translucent quality of watercolor paint, traditional watercolor paint. Sometimes I use the gouache with watercolor. Yeah, you know, I don't do too many multitasking things anymore. For the yeah, I'm on Ustream right now. We're simulcasting on both platforms. You get a little bit different view of me on Ustream than you do right now on Periscope. And you see my new overalls. Okay, so we have our inspiration photo in front of us. I'm going to start with my lightest value color in the MaimeriBlue, which is permanent lemon yellow. And I don't know that I'm going to copy the image exactly as much as do a, you know, little piece inspired by the colors in the image. That's what really drew me. And if you've missed the image, this is the image from a friend of ours, Brent Frazier. He's a photographer. This is his 2013 calendar. And then I'm going to come in with Indian yellow. While the paint, the lemon yellow is wet, and I'm going to put some of that in. It's a gorgeous image, isn't it? Whether you try to duplicate it exactly or you just use it as inspiration for colors and, you know, a mood, kind of a mood painting. You know, my teacher, Pauline Agnew, she has a name for that, and I can't remember what it is this morning, but she does these beautiful, like, abstract, expressive landscapes where it's really about painting the impression of the landscape and not duplicating the landscape that you see. And she has a course coming up. If you're interested in that type of thing, you should look into her. Okay, so now I'm going to go in. I have this really cool color in the MaimeriBlue. Honestly, I bought it because of the name. Oh, thank you. So the first one, this is the name of the paints are MaimeriBlue. And they're French or Italian, I don't remember. The first one I did was lemon yellow, then that's Indian yellow, which is more of an orangey. I bought this next one because of the name, Dragon's Blood. Like, I just, you know, because I'm a nerd. I thought, wow, I like that name, Dragon's Blood. So we're going to just use the photo as inspiration, and we're going to put some of this Dragon's Blood in here. And we're just going to work from the center and work out. MaimeriBlue. Oh, here. I think that's how you spell it. MaimeriBlue. It is possible I spelled it wrong on the color key. Because, if you guys have been following me, you know, my name is neither Grace or Patience, and I certainly was not an English major. I had to redo my meme quick this morning because after I started posting it, I realized there was a spelling error. So, you know, MaimeriBlue. Like, yes, like Maridel. So I'm actually going to switch to a bigger brush because I feel like I'm being too fiddly with that small brush. And I want to add some water and blend these edges out a bit. Not too much. I'm going to take some more Dragon's Blood, though, because I think I lost some of the There we go. Oh, I think that was the wrong color. Well, that's okay. I think that was the next color, which is primary magenta. Yeah, it was. That's all right. I was going to add it eventually anyways. So their primary magenta is really, really bright. I love my Daniel Smiths. Don't get me wrong. I'm still a Daniel Smith girl. I love their paints. They're made here in the USA, which I love. And they're easy to get. I am trying to see if they'll send me like a coupon code or something for you guys. I'm like, I'm not good at writing these emails to companies, but I am trying. So that's just a little bit of the primary magenta. And the dragon's blood, and we're working from the center out. So now we're going to go with this. So that was, we're up to here. And we're using the sunset picture as our inspiration piece. And, you know, it has like every color almost in the rainbow in the piece. So we're going to use that. I have a few different purples on here. Purple is one of my things. I love purples, but I hate mixing purple. I'm going to use, I think, the Garnet Lake. I love this color. And this is just working wet on wet. Those of you who have been doing color watercolors know what that means. You're putting the wet paint on wet paper. You're not putting it on dry. Yeah, pink is another one that's a pain to mix. And the primary red magenta in the MaimeriBlue, look how pink that is. For those of you on Periscope, I'll put it flat. They also have some really great, you know, turquoise colors. And you all know I love my turquoise. They have some really great earth tones. You know, Mary, I always think of you and your art as being very, like, earthy with earth tone colors, lots of browns. Dark reds. And I love that because I just totally don't do that. And when I try, it just doesn't look good. Yeah, the spot sample is fabulous. Oh, see, Brandy, I need you for ideas. That's a great idea. I'm terrible at about writing the letters. Okay, so now I'm going to go back to the first color we used, the yellow, and I want to put little bits of it here. The spot sample chart of that Daniel Smith has, and I, you know, they don't, all the brand manufacturers don't have that. Golden does have one for their coir. They're fabulous because you can try a lot of the samples of their colors without investing, you know, sometimes hundreds of dollars into a set of watercolor paints. Now, when I'm putting this yellow here, I'm going to be really careful it doesn't blend with the purple. Because then I'll get brown. And we're inspired by the sunset sky. There's no brown in the sky. I do have this black dot on here because I spilled something on there, but that's fine. And then I'm going to go back to, let's see, the Indian yellow. Let's put some of this in. In a way, I'm thinking as I'm doing this, this is kind of a takeoff on the galaxy. It's a similar thing. We're blending colors. And you're working with the wet colors. Oh, I have chat. Oh, sorry. I haven't been paying attention to Ustream. Yes, I can see. I can hear all of you guys over there. Let's see. Hello. I am, and this is wet. I'm working wet on wet. Yeah, the most awkward part about doing Periscope and Ustream together is holding two conversations at the same time. And remembering to look at the chat. You know, I'm used to my Ustream chat not working, but my husband, brilliant tech guy that he is, figured out a workaround around that. So now we are able to take care of that. And I honestly would have the HD camera on regardless because you get a better picture when I download it to YouTube. I have a tech husband. I only know enough to just be dangerous. So, you know, I get myself into a lot of trouble. So I'm still using the first like five colors. I haven't started adding any blue yet. I'm using the sunset picture as inspiration. Yeah, I'm, you know, like I said, I only know enough to get me in trouble. And, you know, then I get myself in trouble and the husband just shakes his head, you know. After 30 years, I don't think he knows what to do with me. He just shakes his head. And nothing that I do surprises him anymore, I have to say. Okay, so then, and then the Garnet Lake, which is our purple. So now I'm not going to do so much blending because there are these streaks of light coming out from the center in the inspiration photo. And I'm going to let it blend if it wants to, but if the paper has dried and I'm getting these lines, I'm okay with that. In the midst of all of this, somebody popped up on Facebook chat just now and wrote something. I think it was one of my admins for the Facebook group, so... but I didn't see it. Hopefully everything's all right. So this is interesting. I like just doing these kind of blending exercises inspired by a photo or not. Maybe just inspired by your favorite colors. They're fun to do. You learn a lot about mixing color on paper and working wet on wet or wet on dry. And what you can and can't do with your watercolors, what kind of effect you can get by just playing with them like this. You know, it's funny. Everybody says I'm over on Ustream. They're talking about how difficult it is to simulcast, and it's not easy. It is difficult, and how brave I am to put myself out there. And that's something I've heard before, in conjunction, especially with my YouTube channel. It's funny too, because I'm an introvert, and I'm live broadcasting terrifies me more than putting a video up there, which also was terrifying the first time I did it. So now I'm going straight into, I'm skipping a few colors, and this is one that's called turquoise green. Isn't that a beautiful color? The MaimeriBlue paint, blue paints are known for their, Well, yeah, it's very therapeutic in a way. So MaimeriBlue paints are known for their bright, vibrant colors. And again, that's how you spell. MaimeriBlue has a couple different lines of watercolor paint. The MaimeriBlue are the artist grade. No problem. Have a good dinner. This will be up on Ustream, and also it'll be on YouTube later. So now I'm going to take our turquoise blue, and I'm going to come in here around the edges. I'm going to mostly go onto the white paper, but if it blends with some of the other colors on here, I'm okay with that. Before I get too far, I'm going to come back with some water. To encourage it to move around. You can't do too much lifting with artist grade watercolors, generally speaking, because they stain. Oh no, I probably should. I know when my daughter was little, they thought she had maybe a learning disability. Actually, they weren't sure if it was a learning disability or speech impediment. And those of you with kids who've gone through that know they have this whole testing process that you do. And we were doing the ADHD test, and for answering questions, the questionnaire. And my husband leaned over my shoulder and whispered to me, "Honey, Becca doesn't have any of these, but you have all of them." So that just gives you a clue. So I have issues. Yeah. What's that? The website for the questionnaire? That would be interesting to do. So before I get too far. No, see, when I grew up in the 60s, they didn't diagnose any, you know, kids generally with any of these things that they do now. They just told my mom, honestly, they told my mom that there was just something wrong with me and that maybe she wasn't holding me enough. And if you don't believe me, go into my Facebook group and my mom is a member. You can ask her. She'll tell you. We're pretty open that way. Yeah. So then as an adult, when I figured out what it was, you know, she's the first one I called, and the MaimeriBlue or artist grade, they do have a student grade, but it's not MaimeriBlue. It has a different name. And they're very bright. They're known, the MaimeriBlue are known for having these bright, vibrant colors, which is why I invested in a few of them, because I thought that these few colors would complement my Daniel Smiths very well. Because generally speaking, when I'm painting for myself, I don't always just stick to one brand. I have so many brands, and some of them have colors in them that are just gorgeous. And you could keep fiddling with this and fiddling with it and fiddling with it, but isn't that just pretty? And what I would recommend that you do is that you, at some point, let it dry before you come in with more layers. Which I don't know how to do. But isn't that gorgeous? Just inspired by the colors I see in that sunset. Crud, I need a palette knife or something flat. Let's see. I'll use this like knitting needle thing. So I'm going to take this off of here. And that's the MaimeriBlue paints. That's just a few of the colors in the palette. It's a similar, yeah, this is, you know, again, I could spend a lot more time than we're going to have in the hour, and I could sit and do the sunset, and I probably will at some point. But just having the inspiration photo with the colors and playing with the paint, I mean, and wouldn't this just be a great background to a journal page or something? You know, you could do some stamping, splattering on it, white dots for stars. You could darken up the edges. I mean, these colors are just beautiful and bright and vibrant. So some of the other colors that I own are Scanafretti. Yes, that's a good idea. So some of the colors I own are, here's Ultramarine. This is a color I didn't use on that other painting. This is their Ultramarine Blue. So if you're going to buy paints, any paints, watercolor, acrylic, Ultramarine Blue should be one that you own, because it's a good mixing, blending color when you're creating other colors. Prussian Blue is an option. It's an optional color. I like it because it's more of a turquoisey blue, a dark blue. I love to use Prussian blue when I'm doing seascapes because I think it's just a beautiful water, ocean color. Yes, one of my favorite blues. I own Permanent Green Light, which is a, oops, I didn't get all the blue off my, yeah, Payne's Gray. Love Payne's Gray. I didn't get all the blue off my brush. Okay, Permanent Green Light. Which is a really beautiful light green and yet still fairly vibrant. Hooker's Green, which is a good basic green. If you're only going to buy one green, buy Hooker's Green. And when I picked the colors for my palette, other than the Dragon's Blood, which I honestly just bought because I fell in love with the name, I picked the colors on purpose to be a minimum of things that I could work with. What's next? Ultramarine Violet. I have one too many violets in my palette because I can't help myself. This is a good basic purple color. Permanent Violet Reddish, which is very similar to Garnet Lake. And if I had to do it again, I probably wouldn't own both of them. But isn't that a pretty purple? Like, I couldn't help myself. I love purple. Look at that. Sepia, because I love sepia as one of my favorite brown colors. It's a kind of a gray brown, a black brown. I love maybe even a little bit greenish. This purple is called Permanent Violet Reddish. And this brown is sepia. And then, of course, y'all know if you've been watching me, of course I bought Payne's Gray. And their Payne's Gray, some Payne's Grays are not as blue as others. Theirs is nicely blue. I love the color of their Payne's Gray. And then I got another yellow. You should have two yellows, two reds, two blues at minimum. This is a little bit darker than the permanent lemon yellow. This is primary yellow. It's a little bit darker, a little bit brighter. And then this is green blue. And these are the only MaimeriBlue paints that I own. And this is after going a couple of different times to buy paint. Like when I'm in a Dick Blick, I'll buy like one or two tubes. Yeah, this is a really pretty teal blue. So that combined with this, these are the MaimeriBlue colors that I own. I own 10 of them, but they have hundreds of colors. So they're gorgeous. Gotta take this off again. What do I do with my, there it is. I lost my stick. I think this is double-ended knitting needle. I don't remember. I don't knit anymore, so. Alrighty. So now we have the Prima watercolors and we opened up the tropicals. Yeah, we opened up the tropicals. The MaimeriBlue come in tubes. I have them. Hang on, I can show you. Let's see. In there. My low-tech storage for my paint tubes. They come in tubes like this, and you can get them at Dick Blick. I know has them, and that's where I get them from. I don't know about some of the other online companies. They may have them, they may not. What do you call it? Tubes. Yep, yeah, economical. You got it. All right. So now let's play with these this is the tropical, which is the brightest one of the three Prima sets that they came out with. They came out with three sets. This is the one with the brightest colors in it. I haven't swatched any of them, so let's do that first. The metal box is from, okay, you can get the metal boxes at Dick Blick. But they're really expensive, and they only have the schmink. Go to jacksonsart.com. It's a UK-based company, and even with shipping to the US, it's still half the price of the Dick Blick box. So go there. And it's the same box without the schmink brand on it. The Prima comes in a box. just go to the Jackson's Art website and type in metal palette and it'll come right up. So this is the green that's in here. Look at that. And here I will, yep, that's it, Jackson's Art. So here's the MaimeriBlue paints that I own. I don't have a green that bright. Here's the next color, which reminds me of like a yellow ochre-y color. It's beautiful though. Look at the pigments just move on that paper so easily. Here's a blue. It looks like an ultramarine blue, although again, they don't have names. That's probably one of my gripes, no names. But they move beautifully on the paper. Here's the green. It's a beautiful, you know, this reminds me of Golden's Fluid Acrylic in Green Gold. I think that's a gorgeous color. Yeah, I prefer color names rather than numbers. That's going to bug me. This is an orange. Look at that. Beautiful. Looks like a pyrrole orange. They move gorgeously on the paper. Here's another green, darker green. Red. Ooh. That's pretty. This looks like it's a purple. Yep. So compared to the brightest, vibrant watercolors I own, which would probably be MaimeriBlue, although I do own a few of the Quar and they're pretty bright, these are pretty comparable. There's another yellow. Nice. That's more of a true primary yellow. Here's another red, but it looks like a pinkish red, like a magenta. Nice. All right, we have another one here. And I've lost track. I don't know where the box is, so. Oops. I think this might be like a Prussian blue. Yeah. So whether you buy your watercolors in cakes, like these are cakes, or tubes, like the MaimeriBlue, there's no reason you have to work with them out of the tube. You can squeeze them into these little pans like I did with the MaimeriBlue. I haven't seen yet, but let's do that next. Yeah, me too. So this is the earth tone, the brown that's in the tropicals. This is the tropical set. It's a dark earthy brown. That's a nice color. It doesn't look like there's any duplicates. So the first thing you should do when you buy new watercolors is you should do one of these kind of things. You should experiment with them. And yes, the pigment load looks fabulous. You should experiment with them, play with them, do a color key. It doesn't look like there's any duplicates. I don't see any duplicates. Now this is the set that I think has metallics in it. So, which is the decadent pies. which is a funny name for a set of watercolors, but yep, this is the set that has metallics in it. I already forgot what number that was. 26. So some of the larger brands, more expensive brands like Schmink, have metallics in their large set. They're the 48 pan set, which I have. Some brands don't make metallics, but Prima is making metallics. There's a silver and a gold in here, and I think the white that's in here may be a pearl. It looks like it's metallic. This is more of a muted, reminds me of like a shabby chic colorway. That may not be what they intended, but that's what it reminds me of, because the colors are, except for the metallics, they're muted. And even, yeah, I bought the Gambi because I wanted to have some that I used with my mixed media, and I didn't have to worry about contaminating them with, you know, an acrylic brush or, you know, matte medium or something, and then kicking myself because I got acrylic paint in the Schminks. I think they probably did, because they do a lot with shabby chic stuff. So the one thing you should never do once you've been using your watercolors, after you're done, don't close the box up. Leave it open and let them dry out, because if you close it up, they're going to get moldy, especially if it's a tube watercolor. Let it dry, exactly. So my only gripe with these so far is having to do this and write the number on the bottom. Gotta let it dry. Leave them open and let them dry. Now I did take one of my small metal palettes and I took this insert out and I glued these little plastic pans down. Actually, I didn't glue them. I put magnets on them and I just put them down in here without that, because you can fit lots more pans in there if you do that. And you probably, if you want to keep using the insert, you could put magnets on the back of some of these half pans and you could get more colors in the middle. Or you could put a little water brush in the middle and to make a travel kit. These little boxes are great travel kits. There's all kinds of chat over on Ustream, but it all surrounds other Ustreamers and who has great broadcasts. Yeah, Inky Obsessions, over you guys over at Ustream, Patty Tolly Parrish. You know, watch her. She's fabulous. So yeah, this is a pain in the neck. When you get like Schmink, they come this way too, and they're a pain. I lost what color that was. Holy cow. What's this one? 36. So this one must be 35. So they are coming in order. But that's interesting. The first one was like 16 to like 20 something. This one is in the 30s, 20s to 30s. So that's interesting. Thank you. Yeah, join the Facebook group. And I just hit 1,000 members over in Facebook and in Facebook. Well, yay, yay. In the Facebook group. And I just hit 5,000 on 5,000 on YouTube. And I saw that, Kelly. I posted a bunch of goodies for the group members, including a free lesson that's just for them. So you have to sit and unwrap them all. So I'm going to get them wet. Now I have to say these are half pans. So this is one thing I want to point out to you guys. So this is half pans. This is a full pan. So You can get the pans empty. You're welcome. And there's also the free lesson and a bunch of, there's a bunch of stuff coming. So you can get the pans empty so that you can refill them from your tubes. And you can order full pans or half pans. If you get half pans, you can get more colors in your palette. But the full pans are a little easier to use because they're bigger. It's a bigger surface space to get your brush into. Sometimes when you order these pre-filled pans, then they're not completely full. I have to, which bugs a lot of us who spend a lot of money on watercolor paint. And I gotta say, Prima did not do that. These are really full all the way to the top. Oh, good. I'm so glad over on Ustream, Angel. I'm so glad. And Kelly, I did see that. So we're in the same city over on Periscope, Kelly McNeil. I always kind of worry that one of these days I'm going to be like at the grocery store and somebody's going to go, Gina, and I'm going to go, oh, God. Not that it'll be bad. I think it's just going to freak me out. Oh, yeah. Okay. Los Gatos. My favorite art supply store is Lens Art over in Santa Cruz. I love that place. Look at this pink color. So look up Lens Art, L-E-N-Z, and go check them out. They're near downtown. They've been there forever, almost as long as I've been alive. Which I shouldn't tell. Yeah, that's it. They're fabulous. And they have everything. They have wonderful free demos. Free demos. And year long. And they're the ones that I went to the paper demo and I got free paper samples. And then also, in the same demo, they had the Sennelier watercolor guy. And I got some samples of that, too. Don't be afraid of watercolors. I see some people talking about it over on Ustream. Art store demos are a great place to get little samples of things that you can try before you commit to buying the whole big thing. I go to University Art too, but they don't have the selection that Lens Art does, to be honest. There's nothing wrong with University Art. I love the place. I applied for a job at the place. They didn't want to hire me. But that's not, you know, that's not here nor there. I'm not young anymore, and I'm not a college-educated artist, and I think that was the problem. But they don't have the selection of stuff that Lens Art has. Lens Art has a lot of different manufacturers and things in there. Crud. What color was that? I lost track, you guys. Are you paying attention? Yay, yay, yay. I don't know what color this is. Oh, 7. There we go. Because I'm talking at the same time I'm doing this. Northern Ontario. This is 9. This looks like a pretty purple. So what do you mean by over on Ustream, Angel's asking me, I know that you have tried, who would you recommend in regards to watercolor paints? Is that what you're asking me, Angel? And I've done one of these where I actually took all my watercolors out, and it's on YouTube. This is the first time I've done it live, where I've taken a partial. And we're not going to do, there's just not enough time on one of these live broadcasts to take all my watercolors out. I have too many. But, you know, if this is something you guys would like to see, we'll do maybe, you know, a couple brands at a time. Next time I'll open them first before I start the cameras. All right, so this is the last one. Yay! Okay, so if I had to tell you a brand of watercolor paint to try, this is going to be my advice to any of you who have not tried watercolor before. If you don't have a budget, I did used to teach painting at a local Michael's store. I actually stepped back from that recently, but well, not recently, in June. I am just teaching out of my home today. Okay, somebody, let's block that guy, block user. We have a troll over on Periscope. All right. So if you have a budget for your watercolors, you know, which most of us do when we first get started, get the best, figure out what your budget is and get the best quality you can afford. If you can't afford too much, then get one of the Artist Loft, or Lowell Cornell has a big set of student cake watercolors. They're in round, they have little round dots, round cakes, and okay, that we might need to block her too. Round cakes by Lowell Cornell. You can get it at Michael's. You do use a 40% off coupon. You get a lot of colors for the price. Yeah, some of you guys, if you're on Periscope and you see some of these people popping up right now, if you can block them, that would be great. So use a coupon. Artist Loft is not bad either. So what I would recommend is, if you don't have much of a budget, then get a student grade set just to try them, to see if you like the medium. Now, if you like the medium but you aren't liking the colors, they're not bright enough for you, that's probably because they're student grade paints. So then you need to move up the ladder a little bit and try some artist grade paints. Start with a small, like 12 color set, okay? And we'll talk about getting the Primas in a minute. Don't get a huge, like, 48 pan set. Where's my... These are expensive. If you have an unlimited budget, sure, go for it. But this one actually has 52 in it. This is the one I use the most. When you move up, start with just a few colors, a cool and a warm yellow, a cool and a warm blue, a cool and a warm red. I'd recommend an orange, a purple, and like Payne's gray. Those are usually my go-to colors in any small palette. I'd recommend Daniel Smith if you're in the U.S. because they're easy to get. They're great quality paints. And yeah, I don't know. They're great quality. Daniel Smith are great quality paints. They're available in the U.S. They're not, you know, exorbitantly expensive. And they're easy to find. We're having some issue with trolls over on Periscope. Sorry, you guys. If you are not in the U.S., Schmink is a great brand. Old Holland is a great brand. Winsor Newton's a great brand. My favorite is Daniel Smith. You can get Daniel Smith tubes in small color sets on their website. They're not expensive. You also can get, for $21-ish dollars, go to danielsmith.com. They have a color dot chart of all 238 colors that they make. So that's a great place to start, because it costs you about $20-ish dollars. You can get the 20. You can get the color dot chart. We're having some serious problems all over Periscope. You can get the color dot chart from Daniel Smith, and you can try all of their colors. It's a professional grade watercolor set, and the little dots go a long way. So I don't think so. I think when you block, it's on the broadcast. So if somebody can help me, that would be fabulous. So when you get the dot chart, they come on big 8.5 by 11 sheets. I cut mine up to put in this little sample book, but you get these dots of paint, and this little dot goes a long way, and you get all of their colors that they make. It's a really great deal. They're the only company I know of that gives you a sample of all their colors. So I would recommend, if you decide after you've tried the inexpensive brand that you like Watercolor, go to danielsmith.com and order their color dot chart. And then try those. And then I would like try each, you know, if you can try each one of the colors, decide which colors that you love, and then, then get the tube if you really love it. Yeah, the little dot goes a long way, especially if you're doing like mixed media and greeting cards and like tags and stuff like that. These little dots go a long way. Golden's Quar watercolors, they have, it's a great travel thing. Now the Quar watercolors, they have samples too, but they only have limited samples. So they have like these earth tones, and then they have this one, which are these colors. And then they have this one. So, and they come with a little piece of paper. So, yay team. Exactly, yay team. My peeps are just fabulous because you guys block them like champs. So, yeah, Winsor Newton doesn't do it. Old Holland, I've been looking. So far, the only two paint companies I've seen that do good watercolor samples are Daniel Smith. And Golden has a few. Daniel Smith is the best one. Brandy is saying over on Periscope that you can get 66 of Daniel Smith colors for $9 on Amazon. If you want the full set, it's like 238 colors or something, and it's like $21 or something, and I do think that one's on Amazon too. You can get it directly through Daniel Smith, but I think you can also get it through Amazon, and you may find it's on Amazon Prime, I'm not sure. All right, so let's try the rest of these Primas because we're on overtime here. All right, before any more trolls come. So I'm going to start down here at the bottom on this one. This is the Decadent Pies, I think. And this is the darker blue. The blue. Look at that, how pretty that is. Now, each one of these colors had a different number. So I'm assuming that means they're slightly different colors. Now, these Prima sets come in sets of 12 paints. They're not horribly expensive. That's a pretty Payne's gray color. It's very nice to be able to try them before you buy them. That's why I love Daniel Smith. They have great customer service that way. All right, so this is the Decadent Pies. Look at these beautiful colors. Now, these Prima sets are sets of 12, like I said. You can get the bright tropicals, you can get the Decadent Pies, you can get the classic, which is just basic primary colors. They're about 20, I forget now how much I paid. I want to say $25 a set. So you can get the set of colors or color, the colorway that's going to appeal to you. You know, if you know you really like the muted, you know, sort of antique, shabby chic colorways, get the Decadent Pies, which has a flesh tone in it, FYI. This is the one that I was saying has, look at that, that's a flesh tone. That's a great flesh tone. You could definitely do a face with that, darken it up a little bit with this color. You could add some of these other colors to it, but that's a great flesh tone color. There's a darker brown in here too, which might be a nice dark flesh tone. Yeah, look at that. And you could mix it with the other flesh tone. And then there's sort of this pale, I want to say like, it almost reminds me of a Titan buff color. It's a beige color, which you really don't see in watercolor paints. And then there's this muted rusty color. I am an enabler, I'm sorry. And then here's the gold. The Decadent Pies has the metallics. So here's the gold. It has a silver. And it has a pearl, but I don't think, I know, sorry. It has a pearl, but I don't know that you're going to be able to see it on camera. Let's see, we can maybe put it over something that's on here. There you go. So there's a pearl. And the nice thing about the pearl is you could mix it with one of the other colors to make it metallic. So you could mix it with the blue. And I'm only an enabler because I love art supplies. I stop watching all of your guys' YouTube haul videos because it just makes me want to buy more stuff. It's a good thing. Exactly. There could be other things I could be addicted to besides art supplies. So I love the way the Primas are pigmented. I think that they're a great starter kit. If you know, I haven't seen them in a store yet, but you can get them on Amazon if you could afford the like $25 to get it. They come in a fabulous metal box and you get 12 nice colors. Now this is the primary set. That's not what they call it. Classics, the classics. So these are basic, your basic colors. Let's get a fresh piece of paper. All right. So these are your basics, and here's a green. There we go. Look at that beautiful green. It's a nice basic green color. And here's the yellow. Yeah, I love art supplies, and yeah, I just can't help myself. Here's an orange. These are great basic colors. If you just want a basic, you know, primary colors, you could definitely mix your muted tones from these. But there's some great basic colors in here. Here's the red. This set does have a pink in it. Look at that red. Wow. Look at that red. It's beautiful. It has a pink. And you know, this is a beautiful pink. Let me show you something. So Daniel Smith has opera pink here. This is opera pink, and this is the Prima pink. They're pretty close. They're not the same. Oh, let's see. Wait, you can't see on, hold on, you can't see on Periscope. All right, there you go. So here is the Daniel Smith pink, opera pink, and here's the Prima pink. It's pretty, the Daniel Smith's still a little bit brighter, but it's an artist grade paint. But the Prima's pretty close. And you know, when you're doing mixed media and, you know, we're doing it in art journals and, you know, it's never really going to see the light of day until we're long gone. It's not going to be exposed to UV light. So you don't really have, I don't know how much you have to worry about it fading or anything. I think these Primas are, you know, this is a good choice. And these may be light, you know, pretty light fast. I haven't looked into it. This is the primary set, Brandy. So this is the blue. It's a very nice basic ultramarine blue. And it's different than the other blues. I'll finish swatching it and then I'll compare it with the other sheet. There's a pretty light blue turquoisey color. Look at that. It's almost the same color as my shoes. This is the new Prima watercolors. There's a purple. I just got them, so we're swatching them. We did a little experiment painting with the MaimeriBlue paints earlier. There's a brown. This classic set is nice because you have your basic earth tones in here, and which, you know, sometimes with these sets they leave out, because you can mix brown, of course, but if you're like me, you hate mixing brown. Here's a gray, which is pretty. And not a color you see too often. I like that there's a gray. I could see me using this gray in conjunction with some of my other paints. And then there's a black. Look at how dark that black is. Wow, that's nice. See? I just knew right off the bat, Brandy, that I should just get all of them. So here are all the Prima colors. And here they are compared to the MaimeriBlue colors, which are artist grade watercolor, a lot more expensive for these few tubes that I own than all of these sets. So MaimeriBlue, you know, they're not like Daniel Smith, they're like, you know, $10 or $20 a tube. So, you know, each one of these tubes is, you know, a tad pricey. And in exchange, you can get, you know, all of these Prima watercolors instead. I won't tell you how much my schminks were because they were expensive. I definitely think that one of these little 12 watercolor sets from Prima, these are a good way to start. If you can't afford the full price on it from Amazon, then wait until they come into your local arts and crafts store. Ask them when they're going to get them if they don't have them already. If you have Amazon or have Amazon Prime, just go there. That's what I did. And they come in a nice metal box. That's the other thing. They don't come in a cheap plastic box. This is a nice metal kit that you can refill. Again, I said earlier, you can take the insert out that the paints are actually in. You can take this out. And if you wanted to make better use of the box, put little magnets on the back of the pans, glue magnets on the back of them, and then stick them in here. And you can get more colors in that way. This is a full pan. You can get more colors in if you take them out of this insert than you do with it. And if you want to keep the insert in here, you could fit half pans into the center part. I don't know how many. We should probably find out which one. Hold on, I've got pans somewhere. Here we go. Amazon, I love Amazon Prime. It's hard for me to go shopping because of my allergies and my asthma, so I have issue with that. So you can fit, if you took some of these little half pans, and here's one of the inserts like is in here from my travel kit that I took it out. So you can fit more half pans into the center part. You could put magnets on them. I'm allergic to everything. Shopping is a problem. So you can fit six more pans in that center section if you put magnets on them. So you could take, say you have all three of these Prima sets or two of them, and you really want to make up a kit that has your favorites from all of the different sets in it. Why can't you do that? Just take the pans out and move them around. Or maybe you want to use the Prima Classic set with a couple of other watercolors that you have from another set, maybe some tubes. You could put the empty pans in the center and you could fill them from your tubes. Or see, this is a little piece of sponge. This came out of when I disassemble kits and I move things around to make a better kit for me, then I save the pieces. So this is just a sponge from another kit. That fits in there nicely. You could also put a water brush in here. So Koi makes a travel water brush that has a lid in the handle so you can take it apart without the water spilling out. It would fit in here. I know it would. Anybody have any more questions? So next week we're going to do this again with other brands of watercolor. I have Schmink, Daniel Smith, of course the Prima now, MaimeriBlue. I own a few Winsor & Newton colors and some, I have Van Gogh. I'm trying to get some samples of Old Holland and Zecchi. It's an Italian brand. To try. So when I get that worked out, I'll let you know. And I'm also trying to get Daniel Smith or somebody to give us a coupon for you guys to get an online coupon. So I'm working on all of that. Hasn't come through yet. But anyway. So I hope this helped you all out. If you were thinking about buying watercolors, you're trying watercolors, you know, depending on what kind of budget you have, just, I started with a basic student set that had like 12 colors in it. I think with a coupon, I paid like $4 for it. And I decided I loved them. So then I upgraded. So do that. If you don't have as many budget issues as I did when I started, think about going with one of these 12 color sets. I definitely think for the quality, that these Prima sets are a great buy. The box is fabulous and the paints are wonderful. So I would definitely, you know, I like the Gambi, paints. I like Winsor Newton paints. I hate the box. The boxes drive me crazy. I hate the plastic box, and the Gambi comes in a cardboard box. I hate that. So these are fabulous. They took out all of those issues. The only problem I have is the little pans aren't marked, but get a permanent marker out. Don't get the Winsor Newton set, Brandy. I have it. I use it for mixed media, but I hate the box. The plastic box is annoying. Get one of these. I think you'll be happier. And if you're, you know, doing watercolor out and about, it has, of course, this ring you can put on your finger and hold it. I never do that. I just set it on a table somewhere and use it that way. Which set had the metallic? So Decadent Pies had the metallic. This is the classic. And then, what did I, oh, here's the other one. And then this is the brights. So these have really bright tropical colors. And this is the classic, and this is the Decadent Pies. Now, if you look at these compared to these, this is why you should swatch your watercolors. It should be the first thing you do is make yourself a color key, no matter what brand you have, because the way the paints look in the pan is always different than how they look on paper, always. So first thing you should do is do a color key. And if you're messy like me, make a little plastic sleeve for it to go in so that when you're using it and your, you know, water's going everywhere, you don't get your color key wet. These are the Prima. All three of these are the Prima sets. They just came out with them, and I got them on Amazon.com. If you just type in Prima watercolor, these will pop right up. If you want to get some great inspiration photos, go to BrentFraserPhotography.com. This is, again, his 2013 calendar. I haven't seen this year's yet. My husband hasn't brought it home because, you know, it's at his desk. I may have to actually ask him where, if he can get another one for me. I don't know. You're welcome. So I think my two favorite brands now are Daniel Smith and Prima. I still love my Daniel Smiths, but if you're starting out on a budget, these are probably going to be too expensive for you. These are between $10 and $25 a tube, depending on the color. And I poured them into the half pans. If budget's not an issue, I would definitely recommend Daniel Smith. They have a lot of colors to choose from, but you know, get their color sample dot chart first and then see what of the colors that you like. And then buy the tubes. The price is very right on these. Very, very right. All right. I will see you all later. Don't forget the couple most important things. Actually, more than a couple. So if you want to ask me any further questions after we're done, if you want to get inspiration, we have weekly prompts, all that stuff. Join my Facebook group, A Life of Art and Self-Expression. If you want to support me continuing to bring you free content, no matter what platform I'm doing it on, you can shop in my Etsy store. That's a great way. If you want to support the YouTube channel, of course, if you go to the homepage for my YouTube channel in a browser, not in an app, there's a little support button on the right. And don't forget to play. Have some fun. And do something nice for yourself because you deserve it. All right. I'll see you all later. Have a great day. I have got to go run a bunch of errands. Ugh, I got to go to the grocery store. I hate the grocery store. this broadcast will be up on YouTube, hopefully by the end of the day. So don't worry about that. And it will, of course, the recording will be on Ustream. It's going to stay there for, I think, 30 days or something. Ustream, it stays up longer. If you have any questions for me after you watch the broadcast, you can leave a comment on the YouTube video, or you can go over to the Facebook group and ask me questions over there. I'll be happy to answer them, no problem. And enable all of you to play with watercolors. Because, that's what I do, enable. All right, that's it right now, guys. I'll see you all later.